gate. Stop playing around, Danny. I'm standing out in the open here for crying out loud.
I got orders not to let you in, Miss Piper. I'm sorry. I'm just doing my job.
Ooh, just doing your job. Protecting Diamond City means keeping me out, is that it? Oh, look, it's the scary reporter.
I'm sorry, but Mayor McDonough's really steamed, Piper. Saying that article you wrote was all lies. The whole city's in a tizzy.
You open this gate right now, Danny Sullivan. I live here. You can't just lock me out. Open up. You. You want into Diamond City, right?
I just got here, but yeah.
Shh. Play along. What's that? You said you're a trader up from Quincy? You have enough supplies to keep the general store stocked for a whole month? You hear that, Danny? You gonna open the gate and let us in, or are you gonna be the one talking to crazy Myrna about losing out on all the supply?
Jeez, all right. No need to make it personal, Piper. Give me a minute.
Better head inside quick before old Danny catches on to the bluff.
This place, Diamond City. What is it?
Oh, the Green Jewel? She's a sight. Everyone who's anyone in the Commonwealth is from here, settled here, got kicked out of here. A big wall, some power, working plumbing, schools, and some security goons are what make Diamond City the big monster it is. Oh, love it or hate it. You'll see for yourself soon enough. Let's go.
Piper, who let you back inside? I told Sullivan to keep that gate shut. You devious, rabble-rousing slanderer. The level of dishonesty in that paper of yours. I'll have that printer scrap for parts.
Ooh, that a statement, Mr. McDonough? Tyrant mayor shuts down the press. Why don't we ask the newcomer? You support the news? Because the mayor's threatened to throw free speech in the dumpster.
What newspaper are you talking about?
Mine. Public Occurrences. And we're the hard look at the truth. So are you with us or not?
Always believed in freedom of the press.
Rightly so. A true medium for the people.
Oh, I didn't mean to bring you into this argument, good sir. No, no, no. You look like Diamond City material. Welcome to the great Green Jewel of the Commonwealth. Safe, happy, a fine place to come. Spend your money, settle down. Don't let this muckraker here tell you otherwise, all right?
What are you two arguing about, anyway?
What do you think? Print lies and everybody's happy, but if you print the truth...
Now... Was there anything particular you came to our city for?
I'm trying to find someone.
Trying to find someone? Who?
My son, Sean. He's less than a year old.
Wait, your son's missing? Oh, you hear that, McDonough? What's Diamond City Security doing to help this man, huh? This isn't the first missing persons report to come through here, and now we have an infant who's been taken?
Don't listen to her. Well, I'm afraid that our security team can't follow every case that comes through. I'm confident that you can find help here. Diamond City has every conceivable service known to man. One of our great citizens can surely find the time to help you.
Well, sure. And a mayor of a great city must know everyone. Who can help me?
Well, there is one private citizen, Nick Valentine, a detective of sorts who specializes in tracking people down, usually for debts or whatnot. Now, I have to get going. I'm sorry Diamond City Security doesn't have time to help, but I'm sure Mr. Valentine charges a reasonable fee.
This is ridiculous. Diamond City Security can't spare one officer to help. I want the truth, McDonough. What's the real reason security never investigates any cases?
I've had enough of this, Piper. From now on, consider you and that little sister of yours on notice.
Yeah, keep talking, McDonough. That's all you're good for. I'm impressed. Not everyone can claw information out of McDonough's tight-fisted hands. Why don't you stop by my office after you see Valentine? I think I just found my next story.
Is one of those things. It's that secretary of
the newcomer, huh?
Talk to Ed at the wall.
His ties. Oh, Nick.
Something wrong?
Another stray coming in from the rain. Afraid you're too late. Office is closed.
I know you must be busy, but I won't take much of your time, miss. It's important.
You're right. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to be rude, but it's just... the detective... he's gone missing.
Do you have any idea how I could find him?
He disappeared working a case. Skinny Malone's gang had kidnapped a young woman, and he tracked them down to their hideout in Park Street Station. There's an old vault down there they use as a base. I told Nick he was walking into a trap, but he just smiled and walked out the door like he always does.
Hey, I'd love to help, but there's a small matter of expenses.
Money, huh? I do have 125 caps in the old rainy day fund.
Who's this Skinny Malone character?
I don't know much about him, but he's from Good Neighbor, and that means he's in the well-pressed suits and machine gun school of thuggery.
I'll find him. You have my word.
Thank you. Nick should be easy to spot. He's always wearing that old hat and trench coat getup. Please, hurry.
That food. Only one thing worth buying in the dugout inn, and that's the booze.
Combat zone.
Hey, gotta eat. What can I talk?
Just a minute, Yeti. I am in middle story. So then, I am crossing river, wearing nothing but a smile.
You read the paper? Damn sense. Hiding among us.
Glass of wine, Wally.
Sir.
Seriously?
Surely you meant to leave that rubbish where you found it.
What the?
Kyle, no!
Is that a Pip-Boy?
Give my left arm for one of those.
You keep looking at me like that. I start thinking yours. Head on inside. Looking for Diamond City? Just follow the signs.
If that's what you want.
Someone there?
I'm telling you, joining Skinny Malone's crew was the best decision we've ever made. Look at this place.
I still say Malone's weak. We caught that detective snooping around, and what does he do? Locks him up. Like he ain't got the balls to just kill him.
Well, don't let his new girl hear that. She'll start swinging that bat of hers at your face until there ain't no face left.
Rubbish.
Hey,
I'm afraid you'll have to do better than me!
you.
Picking up hostile life sign.
So loud. Hello? That you, Skinny? Darla?
So I got a question. Why the hell would anyone build a vault out of a subway station? This place is like the opposite of airtight.
Because they weren't planning to use it, you moron. We used to pull this kind of con
hey.
All the time back after the war. Get a bunch of union boys to work some construction job that would go nowhere. Keep everyone on payroll.
Get him.
Howdy-ho!
I... Well, be my fault.
Really? Is that...
Hey.
Yes, sir?
Hey.
On him. Hold.
Of course, sir.
Over there.
All right.
I'm gonna have fun with you.
Over here.
How you doing in there, Valentine? Feeling hungry? Want a snack?
Keep talking, meathead. It'll give Skinny Malone more time to think about how he's gonna bump you off.
Don't give me that crap, Valentine. You know nothing, you got nothing.
Really? I saw him writing your name down in that black book of his. Lousy, cheating card shark, I think were his exact words.
What the?
Thank you. muscles for brains ain't coming back. Get this door open!
You gotta hack that terminal to open up this door.
Ah, my knight in shining armor. Question is, why does he come all this way, risk life and limb for an old private eye?
My son, Sean, is missing. He was kidnapped, but I don't know who took him or where they went.
Missing kid, huh? Well, you came to the right man, if not the right place. I've been cooped up in here for weeks. Turns out the runaway daughter I came here to find wasn't kidnapped. She's Skinny Malone's new flame. And she's got a mean streak. Anyway, you got troubles, and I'm glad to help. But now ain't the time. Let's blow this joint. Then we'll talk.
Nice.
Malone's crew here used to be small time. Muscled out of the old neighborhood by bigger players. Until they found this place. Don't know what happened to the previous owners, but they're not exactly around to charge rent. An empty vault. Perfect hideout. Hold up. I hear some of them coming. There they are. How do you want to play this?
His only job is to check on the prisoner. Why does that take so fucking long, huh? Hey, Dino! Quit! Razzle that detective and get down here! Where the heck is he?
Hey, Valentine.
Let's keep moving. Talk once we're out.
Psst. Something you need, sir?
What was that?
Drop him.
Here comes some mobsters.
Now, where'd you go?
Thank you.
Hard and loud, huh? Well, it gets the job done. Too bad for whoever cleans up the floors. This door's on the fritz. Let me see if I can get...
Nick.
You really want to do this here? With these human cockroaches around every corner? Almost got... There we are. Hell of a lot easier to do when the lock isn't on the other side.
What? Attack. There ain't nothing here.
They have taken over the castle. Which I guess is there some years ago, but it hasn't been for a while.
Are you playing hide and seek? That's one way to get that coolant pumping. Anybody now?
How about some music? Orange colored sky by Nat King Cole. I love it.
Think they're gone for good?
Sure.
Even break a sweat. Not that it's an option.
Enjoy your coffin!
More stairs? Who built this damn vault? A fitness instructor?
Time for you to take the fall!
Hiding? Well, fee-fi-fo-fum.
There! Waste them!
There's something out
there. Think you know the...
Getting along. Skinny Malone and the rest of his boys are waiting for us somewhere. The name's, ironic, but don't let that fool you. He's dangerous. Another locked door. Shouldn't be too hard. Okay, I got it. But I hear big fat footsteps on the other side. Once we step through this door, get ready for anything.
You come into my house? Shoot up my guys? You have any idea how much this is gonna set me back?
I wouldn't be here if it weren't for your two-timing dame, Skinny. You ought to tell her to write home more often.
Oh.
Hey.
Poor little Valentine. Ashamed you got beat up by a girl. I'll just run back home to Daddy, shall I?
Should've left it alone, Nikki. This ain't the old neighborhood. In this vault, I'm king of the castle. You hear me? And I ain't letting some private dick shut us down now that I finally got a good thing going.
I told you we should have just killed him! But then you had to get all sentimental. All that stupid crap about the old times.
Darla, I'm handling this. Skinny Malone's always got things under control.
Oh, yeah? Then what's this guy doing here, huh? Valentine must have brought him here to rub us all out.
What's the deal with you people and Nick, anyway?
Darla's a runaway. Her father wanted me to bring her back home. Turns out she skipped town to be with my old pal Skinny Malone, mob boss. Never thought he'd manage to scrape together a big enough crew to take over a vault. Guess life's full of surprises.
Hey, who's running this show here? You got something to say? Say it to me!
Look at yourself. Darla's playing you for a sap. You're better than this. You're better than her.
You're right. Things have gone nothing but south since she walked into my life.
What are you talking about, Skinny?
I'm saying you're dragging me and this whole operation down a bad road, Toots. We're through.
Well, fine then. I'm going back home. I don't need you, you fat ass!
They always gotta hit you where it hurts. Now what am I gonna do about you two? I know. I'm gonna give you until a count of 10. I still see your ugly faces after that. I'm gonna start shooting until there ain't no more bullets left in this whole vault.
We better get out of here, fast.
One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven.
Commonwealth sky. Never thought anything so naturally ominous could end up looking so inviting. Thanks for getting me out. How did you know where to find me, anyway? Not many people knew where I went.
Your secretary, Ellie, she sent me.
She did? I should give her a raise. Now, you mentioned something about your son, Sean, and how he went missing. I want you to come to my office in Diamond City. Give me all the details. Besides, I think you've earned a chance to sit down and clear your head.
I'll meet you there.
See you in Diamond City.